What is up, guys? Recently, I did a Halloween update and I talked about five potential problems for Halloween kills. So I thought, let's flip it. Now I'm gonna give you five potential signs of promise for Halloween kills. Let's do this. What is up, guys? It's been a while since I've been sitting in this chair. And I'm doing five videos right now, so I'm definitely gonna need this, and I'll probably finish it by the end of the second video. But why not start it off with a nice Halloween kills update? Not really an update, it's more a tack on to the last update that I did, because I only talked about problems. Now I'm gonna talk about the promise, the good things that could come out of Halloween kills. And if you'll notice, I gotta give a big shout out to Blake Garner, one of my Killer Flicks mods, good friend. He told me, he's like, hey man, if you go to Books A Million, they have a Halloween 6 t-shirt. And I literally dropped what I was doing, headed straight down there. Didn't even look back. And sure enough, I found this shirt. It is glorious. I got this one. I actually got a Nightmare on Elm Street and a Friday the 13th, the final chapter shirt too. But God, this is glorious. I love it. So, and also I stopped over at Hot Topic and I picked up this H2O limited edition exclusive Michael Myers. You all know my problems with H2O. You all know that Barry from Wolfman's Got Nards is the opposite. He loves H2O. He loves it so much, I actually asked him, I was like, hey, do you want me to send you one of these? He's not a Funko guy, though, so I don't think he would mind me telling you that. But I freaking love this thing. That thing is glorious. But anyway, let's get into the topic at hand. Five potential signs of promise for Halloween kills. I'm excited for this movie, guys. Don't think that I'm not. I really am. I mean, next year is going to be a big year for Halloween fans. Possibly another Howlstream kills within the next couple months. We'll see. But anyway, I'm going to cheat. I'm going to give you an honorable mention too. I got my notes right here. I actually have my computer just sitting right here, so I can, you know, I have easy access, right? But first off, an honorable mention, introduce a wild card that actually works. If they learn from their mistakes, from what they did with Sartain in Halloween 2018, and by the way, I am a fan of the character of Sartain. I'm one of the few guys that actually really dug that character. I just think he ended on a sour note. So, I do like wild cards in my horror movies, though, and if they come up with something inventive and crazy, but in a good way, I'm all for that, because it also makes the movie memorable. Number five, Allison and Karen could actually kick ass in this movie. Now, if you remember, I put them on the potential problems, because they could go either direction in this movie. I want them to succeed. I do like Allison as a character very much. I think there's an untapped well with her, and I think if they really focus in on her character, maybe put Laurie Strode in the background, but really let Allison steer the ship in this. Let her have that defining moment with Myers. And also, if I could add on to that, there is like some confusion there, because even though Myers isn't related, Halloween 2018 kind of left that notion into the, I guess, unlearned viewer's mind. Like, there's some people that aren't really Halloween fans that might go into that movie and think, could they be related? And they're not. We all know they're not. And I know that David Gordon Green did not intend for them to be related. So, how do you capitalize on that fact about this movie? That connection, and it's not like a blood connection, but there might be some kind of connection between Allison and Karen and Myers. So, high hopes for them. Number four, the one thing that was 100% awesome in Halloween 2018, the one thing that I've never heard anybody complain about that even didn't like the movie, was John Carpenter's score. So, I think John Carpenter is going to come back with his son, Cody Carpenter, and Daniel Davies, and they're going to just knock it out of the park again. And I'm really curious to see what they bring to the table for the second chapter in this. You could call it the third chapter, you could call it whatever chapter you want, but really, in this particular trilogy, it's the second chapter, which we will get more into that. But like what was done with Halloween 2, Alan Howarth and John Carpenter, I think they elevated the score a little bit, added a little bit more of that synth style to it. Wouldn't it be cool if they kind of did a little bit of that in this score? Maybe add some new elements like they did in Halloween 2018. The one thing that I'm really excited about with this movie is the score, the potential of the score. As a matter of fact, I have it right here. I'm constantly playing this damn thing. I played it right before I started this. I have John Carpenter's like playlist on my phone from Spotify. It's such a repeat listener of a score. And it's one really bright, shining spot to Halloween 2018. It's probably my favorite score out of the whole franchise. I mean that. Number three, this is a middle chapter, and I am always curious about middle chapters. And what I mean by that is the first chapter being Halloween 2018. This is meant to be a trilogy. We already know that now with the announcement of this being Kills and then Ends. Halloween Ends is going to be the last of the, I guess you could call it the David Gordon Green trilogy. And like The Two Towers, like The Empire Strikes Back, middle chapters are always very interesting. And I'm really curious to see what they could do with this middle chapter, because that end, you know, is going to leave it wide open for Halloween Ends. And Jamie Lee Curtis herself has kind of hinted at the tone of these last two movies. And this middle chapter is going to focus more on the characters and the fallout of Halloween 2018. And Halloween Ends is going to be, I guess, the more violent. Which I'm cool with, and I'm curious to see what they do. Still keep that violence in there, of course, but I don't mind focusing on the characters as long as it, you know, moves the story forward, keeps me invested. Because if there's any franchise that begs to know a little more, it is Halloween. The character Myers, I think, is so interesting. And if they want to dive a little bit more into his psyche without going too far, you know, make it more of a question mark, then I'm all for that. Number two, Michael Myers. Like the score, Myers is so good in Halloween 2018. What James Jude Courtney brought to the character was refreshing. Visually, it was striking. He had the movements down. And I'm really curious to see where they take the character in this next movie. And like I just stated before, exploring the character maybe a little bit more. What's he going to do? Maybe give us some more of the stalking aspect that we saw in the original 1978 Halloween. Play around with him a little bit more, but you don't have to go too crazy because he was really great in Halloween 2018. We've already saw those images of what he'll look like in this movie. Obviously, the mask, it doesn't look like it's burned that much, but the guy did have some battle damage in that last movie with his two fingers being blown off. That is a new element to the character, so let's explore a little further. I'm really excited about what they do with Myers in Halloween Kills. But on the flip side of that, you don't want to give too much. You don't want to see Myers in every frame of this movie. I think you have to be sparing with how much you show the character. Maybe don't even show him in full view until like the halfway point and on, which I don't think that's going to be the case by those behind the scenes images, of course. But that's what I would love, actually. Make him more of a mystery. Up to a certain point. And then the number one potential sign of promise for this movie is David Gordon Green. I'm going to give the guy credit. He is a damn good director, and he is a big fan of this franchise. He is the guy that made the pitch, him and Danny McBride, to John Carpenter, to Blumhouse, stating, "We have a vision." And when John Carpenter heard that vision, he was excited. And it is hard to get John Carpenter excited with anything having to do with Michael Myers. But he did it. Halloween 2018 wasn't perfect, but I saw so much potential with David Gordon Green's direction. You could tell that it was a labor of love, which is awesome. I mean, we've seen the behind the scenes photos and everybody looks like they're just having a blast. And that's what you want in these types of movies. I still have faith in David Gordon Green. I still really love Halloween 2018. I do. And if he can make this movie even better, maybe learn from the mistakes, then it's going to be even more awesome. So guys, that's it. That is my top five signs of promise for Halloween Kills. Did I miss anything? Let me know down in the comments. What do you want out of this movie? I'm really curious to hear what you guys think. So anyway, on to the next video. Be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day. And on Fridays, we do Free For All Fridays. Follow me at Drumdums on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and Drumdum out.